GSL Team League. I'm Chase with me, Zartosis. We're the Cassian Archon, and we have a map matchup. I am actually so pumped to see.
Yeah.
I am ganking these build orders right away. Sage against Genius. PvP, one of the more volatile matchups, and it's really all up to Sage to save the day.
It is. Is he up to the task? He has the potential to all kill this team. That is a certainty. Okay, Sage is actually the strategic leader of Protoss, no doubt about it. Sage is on top of the mountain, Hero's halfway up it, and everyone else is down near the starting point as far as strategy goes.
Dude, Sage is so good, but I'm so curious to see how he's going to play this PvP. Now remember, the entire MVP team is just going to be watching this guy, studying him, saying, all right, what's his weakness? How's he playing? Can we wear him out? Can we trick him? Let's see if he can manage to survive this gauntlet MVP has set up for him here at the GSL. In the upper right starting location, this guy's on a roll. You haven't seen him on a roll this bad since BlizzCon last year. Genius. In the bottom left.
And this was a Sage.
Sage. The entire team cheering very loudly, as I could hear behind myself in the studio.
All right, so.
Oh, wow. I don't get it at all.
It's like Whack-A-Mole.
Whack-A-Mole.
Sage.
It's like San's in there or something. Wait, no. I'm the Whack-A-Mole Protoss.
Well, San has been whacked, man. When's the last time you saw him?
Yeah, man. He's actually a dead mole.
He got trapped.
Got taxidermied.
All right,
Artosis question time.
Oh, okay.
Taxidermied animals. Creepy or not creepy?
I used to think they were creepy until Chuck Testa just warmed my heart,
Oh,
man.
God, that video is just so funny.
Tasteless. I have a little thing I want to say about this game right here.
Please.
Genius has been playing so well. Sage, every Protoss should be worshiping Sage as the Protoss god at the moment, as he is.
San just walked into the studio.
What?
Yeah, he's right over there. He just walked by.
Oh, there he is.
Yeah, he just walked behind the camera can.
He's
here to support the team.
Really good friends with them, so why not?
Go ahead.
So, Sage, yeah, I just said how good he is. On the other hand, Genius is playing so well right now. He's playing so well, and you can't imagine how little pressure is on him right now. If he loses, he's still the hero of his team. Not
of course.
Hero.
Yeah.
Like, he is the hero. They have multiple tries left after him. Right? There's only two kills for him.
Well, he's done his part.
So there's still, like, they still have, like, two more players that bring out after him. And that's, he has no pressure, and he's already playing so smoothly. I think there's a good chance that he can take Sage out. So, Genius, two gas, one gate. Sage, the same. I do think that we're going to see Robo builds here.
Could be.
I like Robo on this map, PvP. Colossi, pretty okay. You ever try running up a little tiny ramp against Colossi? No.
No.
Not happening.
You pretty much have to go Colossi on this map. Architecture of it just suits it.
Sage already getting his Robo.
Going out on the map. He wants to make absolutely sure. Oh, nice. Scouting probe got in there.
And actually, Genius, are you going to foregate? No, he's not. I was going to say, he is going to get his robo as well. All right, so both players getting one gate robo. And now they'll probably go up to three gates each. But we could see Twilight Councils. That has been such a popular build. Getting Blink plus Observers is just so mobile
and cool. I
think
it's good on this map, but yeah.
Yeah, no, I completely, infinitely agree with you. There's not a lot of areas that you can actually blink up into their base. You have to go way out of position to actually do it, which makes it basically not worthwhile.
What is he doing?
Well, what's happening here is Sage is grossly out-microing Genius, but Genius got out. He traded Zealot for some Stalker health. I mean, it's not the worst trade I've ever seen in PvP, but meh. All right, so 26 probes for Genius, 27 now, 25 for Sage. Both still producing.
Warp gate completing here.
Very quick Immortal for Genius.
Sage actually looks like he's going to go for an expansion.
You know, Immortal, this is kind of cool. He's skipped his, he's getting an Immortal instead of, oh, I'll talk about that in just one second for Bog Spade, but getting an Immortal instead of an Observer, and that can be really smart because an Observer costs 75 gas. So to skip it, you actually just get more of important units, and it looks like we're probably going to see a Colossus timing here by Genius, like a Colossus all in. I wonder if Sage, actually, he's not going to expand, is he? It's very interesting.
Well, it's weird. He's got that probe there. He's had it there for a while. I think what he wants to do is get his Observer in there, see what his opponent's doing, and then he'll decide if he wants to expand or not. In this case, he will not expand because...
Yeah. Here's what's going to happen, okay? Sage is going to get perfect scouting intel, which is... Well, yeah, he's going to run from that, but he's probably going to skirt inside the base. He doesn't know if that was...
Warp Prism.
Oh, my God. I'm just... completely full of happiness. Okay. Warp Prism against someone going Colossus. When you're going Colossus, both you skip Stalkers almost completely and you do not get Blink. Now, the fact that he's getting Shuttle Speed...
And they're both doing it.
Yeah. They can micro around and pick off so much with that 6 range. Stalkers without Blink will never stop this. It's actually going to be insane. I cannot wait. My heart's beating so quickly because I love this build to death. I love this build tasteless.
And it's
nice
because, you know, he gets the Immortals in there. If his opponent is going for Colossus, he can just drop the Immortals where he needs to drop them and shoot down that Colossus with ease.
These builds are so stolen. They're so stolen.
Oh, did he... No, never mind. It's like his probe. Look out! No.
We're showing the new nerfed APM that doesn't really mean much.
Uh-oh.
Spin spot. He's going to drop those and kill it. Goodbye.
He's like, oh my god, Immortals are good.
Wow, this is actually just so exciting. We do have Genius going for Colossus now that he has this Warp Prism out. Sage is going in with his own now. And in fact, he's staying on Immortals for now and making a Nexus. So two very different strategies going on here, even though they're very similar as well. Very, very. Double shotting probes.
Nice little snipe there. Nice.
So
remember, they're not cool. Making Princess Genius right now has not been making probes for a while. So losing just a few probes in this matchup, pretty huge.
Still up by 32-30, but you're very right. Look at
nice.
That, man. Just insane harassment we see going. I'm surprised Genius isn't doing the same. Genius hasn't really been pushing his Warp Prism around, which he should be. It's going to be so hard to kill a Speed Warp Prism with two Immortals in it right now without Blink. It's just so hard. And out it goes. This is so awesome, man. This is actually like... Oh.
Well, the skill level of this PvP, I guarantee you there's so many people that have never seen a PvP played like this. They don't understand this section of what top-level PvP looks like. Whoa, what are you doing?
This build, I think this is the first time we've seen this build used in the GSL. I've seen it on the ladder and whatnot, but it's awesome to see, man. Look at that. He keeps on just killing off pylons. Warp Prism now goes away and heals. Look at this. This is just... The play is just so good.
You've got to be very careful to not lose that.
Genius is actually just going to all in. He has Thermal Lance, he has Colossi, he has a lot of Zealots. I see this being kind of hard for Sage. You know, he's making his own Colossi, he does not have Thermal Lance, though.
Oh, he accidentally triggered Guardian Shield. That's a mistake, and that Guardian Shield's actually pretty important.
Yeah, he needs everything that he can possibly have. Now, Sage is chasing that with a Warp Prism full of Stalkers. This is how cool this is. Oh my god. Sorry, my commentary isn't better. It's just so awesome. I'm like in shock and awe. Oh! All right.
Tried to bait it in there.
Now, here's the thing. Sage, he has a good number of Immortals. He has more Immortals than his opponent. and he has one Colossus, but his Thermal Lance is way far from done. Genius, on the other hand, has three Colossi with Immortal, Thermal Lance, and he has a lot of Zealots. So we're suddenly going to get into this scenario where the Zealots are just taking hits and the Colossi are owning everything.
All right. He's going to run around here.
So much of this will come down to, can the Immortals of Sage actually hit Colossi?
He didn't hit anything there. He tried to snipe it up from the corner. Nice.
And he is actually. He dropped them off, and he's killing off a Colossus. One Colossus almost goes down. Both his Immortals pretty badly hurt right now. This is absolutely insane.
Whoa.
Killing off these Stalkers for free. Losing a couple Zealots in the way. Damage being done. And Genius' Zealots were stuck there for a very long time. The Immortals being dropped behind, but it looks like, does Genius just have too much here?
Well, I think he's done too much damage.
I think so as well, Tasteless. The supply of Sage has plummeted to 36 against 87. And this is definitely going to be it, man.
Yeah, this is game right here. Nice micro here for both guys, but look at the numbers. GG, as Genius has taken out Sage.
Just get like 3 or 4 kills against top caliber pros?
Apparently.
Sage unhappy with this.
Well, I think the entire team has to be unhappy with this. As good as Genius is, I never would have expected him to be the guy who's all killing.
Yeah, he just owned everyone, man. He looked so good there. I love that all-in he just did. I love the fact that both of them went speed Warp Prism with Immortals. It was so powerful.
It was very high-level play. And unfortunately, the team NSSO that was doing so well for so long has been upset by MVP.
That's right. The two top seeds coming to the team league will not be in the finals, TSL and NSSO. They both owned up the regular season, got high seeds, got to skip around, and then lost to the two underdog teams, Prime and MVP.
I know.
Those are the underdog teams. Wow.
Damn.
Genius and his ascension back up to Gosu-ness, man. I'm such a fan. I so hope he gets back into Code S next season.
He is so good. He had great PVZ, great PVT, great PVP.
Yeah, he did.
They threw everything they had at him. I don't think anybody, maybe even Genius, expected to all kill.
Genius didn't expect to all kill. There's no way he expected that. You never expect to all kill a team like that, but he played so solid. His builds were great. His strategy was great. You saw a lot of intelligence in his play. He had good builds.
It was very refined.
Yeah, he made the right decisions.
He did the right thing even doing that all in the last game.
That was perfect.
He's like, all right.
Of course that's going to win there.
If you don't play perfectly, you're going to lose.
Exactly. And that's the way you do it when they're down to their last guy and you still have two guys to go. One of them is Dongryu. Yeah, man. Genius.
Well done to Genius.
Two thumbs up.
Yeah, actually 4. Ready? 4 thumbs up for Genius. Not even like 3. Not even like, here, put your thumbs up. It's not even like that. Actually, put your other hand up. It's not even like that either.
No, right? It's not one of those.
No, it's not. It is actually.
If you were like this, I'd have to slap you.
No, man, I would never do that.
Good.
Man, I just can't believe how good Genius played today. What a twist in this story that's been this season.
Well,
of the
this
GSL
is
team
no one expected what just happened to happen. I actually thought Hosa would take it home today in a very close series.
I think it'd be maybe 2
really
wins
close.
For MVP.
Well, I was thinking it would be like 5-4 Hosa.
Oh,
maybe
really?
Maybe 5-3 at the best. But I tell you, look at that. Genius 4 kills. Keen taking down 1 kill himself. Genius looked as such.
Unbelievable.
I'll be rewatching all those games. Hi, future me.
Oh, no kidding. Well, guys, thank you so much for joining us today. Feel free to add us on Twitter. I'm Call Me Tasteless.
I'm Artosis.
And we're going to have an interview with the players, whether the coaches and the MVPs of the team, which is obviously going to be Genius. And we'll have that up for you guys momentarily. Oh, man. Great job today, Artosis.
You too, Tasteless.
Wasn't my best casting day, unfortunately.
No, mine either. I don't know what was off today, but
well,
it's something
just, you know, some days I'm like, I don't know. It's not my best. I don't know.
Well, We're going to have a Genius interview in a minute here.
Yeah.
Pretty excited to see what he has to say about that. Of course, the team as well. Genius is the MVP of MVP today.
Absolutely.
And I wonder how it's going to go against Prime. It's actually a really interesting matchup because they have like Marine
King,
Prime,
and Creator. Well, it's like a bizarro world finals. You know what I mean? I'm like, well, that would never happen. Like,
I did not expect this. I did not expect this, but I will take this. Dude, the story of the last few days has been Protoss. Protoss has just been kicking ass.
It's been like vaporizing ass.
It's true. It's been like zzz, zzz, inning
ass. It's like the Void Ray beam. It's like shooting at a butt. And he's like, ow, 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 ow.
Starts a little bit.
Expands into the bigger beam. That's what that stuff is. Then it's like, and it blows up. But there's already another ass to be vaporized. So it just goes that one and points, and it's already got extra damage.
Keeps its charge.
MVP 팀인데요. 이로써 MVP 팀은 결승 진출을 확정 졌습니다. MVP 팀 만나보도록 하겠습니다. 오늘 경기의 MVP는 바로 죄송합니다. 네, 정민수 선수입니다. 아, 무려 4키를 기록해서 제가 놀라웠고 발을 죄송합니다. 무려 4키를 기록하고 MVP 선정되셨는데 소감이 어떠신가요?
일단 저 같은 퇴물이 4킬이나 할 줄은 저도 몰랐는데 이렇게 4킬이나 해서 네, 너무 좋아요.
네, 노병은 죽지 않죠. 네. 네, 그동안 팀선배로서 GSTL에서 그렇게 큰 활약을 하지 못했단 말이에요. 근데 오늘 경기로서 마음의 짐을 좀 벗어 던졌을 것 같아요. 어떤가요?
네, 투어 빼고는 다 너무 못해서 그렇게 뭐 미안한 거 그런 건 없었어요.
아, 네.
투어는 투어만
It was feel too sorry defeating the team because they weren't that good.
부러웠긴 했는데 이렇게 다킬 플레이오프에서 다킬해서 네, 너무 좋아요.
네, 그 NS호서의 이준 선수가
4 kills and led his team into the finals.
다 올킬러들이란 말이에요. 이 선수를 다 꺾으셨는데 그 세 명의 선수 중에서 어떤 선수가 가장 쉬웠는지, 어떤 선수가 제일 까다로웠는지 궁금한데요.
이제 저는 경기를 했을 때 세 명 다 쉽게 이겼어요. 그래서
네. 네,
별로 어렵게 이겼다는 생각은 안 하고 있어요.
네, 알겠습니다.
Who's the easiest one to beat?
자,
This is all
선수가 경기 전에서 MVP 팀의 박소 선수만 꺾으면 쉽게 갈 것 같다. 뭐 이런 얘기를 한 적 있는데요. 그 말에 대한 반박을 이제 할 수 있을 것 같아요.
반박이라기보다 수호가 뭐 압도적으로 저희 팀에서 잘했기 때문에 그렇게 반박을 할 수는 없을 것 같고 다른 팀원들도 노력을 하고 있으니까 네. 수호만큼은 아니지만 좀 팀에 더 보탬이 되어서 승을 많이 챙겼으면 좋겠습니다.
네, 이제 결승전 한 경기 남았습니다. 또 좋은 활약 기대해보도록 하겠습니다.
Knows the Donger gives the best
네, 좋았습니다. 네, 최현상 감독님 2회 연속 결승 진출입니다.
Everybody else is doing well too.
생각 나시나요?
He's proud of the team and he's really happy for himself as well. Now we're going to interview the coach.
선수들한테 너무 고맙습니다. 예.
네, 사실 MVP 팀에서는 박수 한 명밖에 없다. 박수 원맨이라고 이런 얘기가 있었는데 오늘 정민 선수도 그렇고 또 저번 주에 김은영 선수도 그렇고 좋은 선수들을 많이 보여줬어요. 이제 그런 오명을 보실 수도 있을 것 같은데.
뭐 누구나 박소 선수를 에이스라고 칭하면서 박소 선수만 잡으면 저희 팀을 이길 수 있다고 다들 그렇게 말을 해요. 하지만 뭐 지난번 IM전이나 오늘 보시다시피 저는 저희 팀 선수들 모두가 에이스라고 생각합니다.
네.
누구나 언제든지
Everyone else thinks that Dongrigu is the only good player in MVP.
그게 이제
but
좀 빨리
you know he says he thinks otherwise.
Because
they have all good players.
나머지 선수들도 예 기대해 보셔도 될 것 같습니다.
And as you guys can see from these games.
팀과 한 경기 프라임팀도 정말 대단한 팀이라고 할 수 있는데요. 프라임팀의 박예식 감독님에게 한 말씀 해주시죠.
아 우선 저희가 프라임팀한테
Any words to the prime team? He'll be facing the finals.
있어서 조금은 예 기대는 아, 우승에 대한 어떤 막연한 기대는 하고 있지만요. 이상하게 조금 안심하는 경기를 저희 팀은 많이 지더라고요. 그래서 이번에는 예, 안심하지 않고 준비 제대로 할 거고요. 그리고 누구나 영화나 드라마는 속편은 재미없다고 하잖아요. 그런데 프라임과 MVP가 같이 준비 열심히 해서 예, 속편의 드라마를 예, 팬분들에게 보여줄 수 있도록 양쪽 다 최선을 다했으면 좋겠습니다.
네, 또 한편의 드라마를 또
기대해보도록
하겠습니다. 네, 말씀 고맙습니다.
예.
네, 이로써 모두 결승팀이
모두 결승했습니다.
전망의 결승전은 바로 다음 주 토요일에 있죠. 저는 그때 다시 뵙도록 하겠습니다.
Everybody says the sequels to the first movies was going to suck. But in this case, it's going to be good, and MVP will win. I am so excited.
Yeah, that finals is going to be a lot of fun, man. I cannot wait.
I love Team League. And I love you guys at home. Thank you so much for joining us here at Golem TV. Please download the Golem Player. Check out our mobile services also. You can watch Golem TV on your phone now here at the GSL. And definitely join us for what will be an epic grand final. Prime against MVP.
Wow, wow, wow.
Yow. It's going to be sick.
I think we're going to see both rosters go pretty deep on that one, Tase, as they are going to be preparing like madmen.
And they should be.
But can genius Donald Draper that team?
I don't know. Damn, well said. That's actually pretty funny, Tase. You're right. A funny guy.
Arena of Legends coming up. Semifinals are going to be MMA against Marine King and Dongregu against July. And then, of course, the finals will come up after that. It's going to be a ZBT in the finals, I bet.
Call me crazy. I think you're right.
I think it's going to be Dongregu in the finals against who I do not know. I'm going to go slightly with MMA.
Could be. Absolutely could be. Mm-hmm. Well, Artosis, it's Friday.
It's Friday?
The day before is Thursday.
It's the day after.
Saturday.
I hope that I have a good night tonight.
Everybody's looking forward to the weekend.
I love that
I'm
going
to go watch that song when I go home.
I know, man. It's such a great song.
What are you doing tonight?
I will go home. I actually still have a little bit of a sore throat I've had all week.
Oh, really?
So I'm going to take it pretty easy. I'm going to watch some VODs, eat some dinner.
Eat some din-din.
Yeah, might play. Whenever I play after GSL, I'm so tired that I just play terribly, so I don't know if I'll play, but...
No, I
think I might just.
I will probably
sleep.
Play StarCraft tonight, but yeah, if I cast in one day and I play the same day, I'm like,
I'll play in the morning probably.
Yeah,
play some StarCrafts.
Yeah, I found I can play before a game. I mean,
before
day
GSL, but not after.
Not after, it's like
it's tiring, man.
Yeah,
at nighttime I'm tired because it's nighttime.
It's sleepy time. Thank you guys again for joining us here. It's been a real treat to cast these games for you guys. I think we're basically done, so we're gonna go ahead and wrap it up. Join us for the finals, which will be coming up soon here at the GSTL. Much love. Take care.